We have a strong storm coming, everyone, and it's showing itself this evening, looking like we're going to have a potential derecho as we go into Friday evening with a lot of intense heat, a lot of lift, also bring a lot of lift overnight as this goes across the Midwest towards the Great Lakes. Overnight for Ohio Valley, going to have storms all night long, also for Saturday night, overnight into Sunday. Then as it builds all day for Saturday, this is where it's going to be along the south, and it's going to be flurrying and shooting a lot of storms in the south. This is where you're going to have a good chance for a potential strong tornado. These storms are pretty intense looking, and they're going to be over and over in the same areas in the south. Potentially getting a low pressure building as it pulls north as you go for the end of Saturday, going in for Sunday as well, with your severe weather risk. Showing that probability is less than a 50-50 chance. Showing GFS is all by itself on all those intense winds. But they could build a little bit more than what we're seeing with the Euro. So what I'm going to do is show you in this video what the weather forecast is on this storm. It's not going to be for the fire risk or the severe weather risk for today or tomorrow. That is exactly the same from this morning's video. I'm going to update you on what this storm system is bringing, because it really is packing a punch. Now, we can't see this far with HRRR just yet, but as we try and see what the future may bring a little bit, we check with the NAM3K. Remember, this always is in different placement, and intensity is usually different, but it gives you an outlook of what could possibly build. And we're starting to see potential banding coming out of this system. Now, this is all pivoting around 6 or 7 o'clock p.m. for Friday. This is where you get a lot of your daytime heating that really builds, and you get into the 70s over here, and this is where you get a lot of convection, a lot of warmer temperatures down below, and this is where it helps the storms bust through the cap, and instability hangs around for a little while with this derecho as well. Now, you can see from here that as you go through the afternoon for Friday, this is where all those 70s pull further to north, even the 80s go further to north, but this is what's going to help with your convection, with your lift, pulling further to the north, making instability. And as you go from 3 p.m. all the way towards 5, 6, even all the way up to 7 p.m., you are going to get thunderstorms going. You do have instability growing into that area. And there is a lot of banding forming, just like we saw with the NAM, showing that it will bow out and potentially get a derecho across multiple states for multiple hours, then go overnight into the early morning hours across Ohio Valley. Then what happens for Saturday? So as it starts bowing out, you can see it's bringing large hail with it. That's what this white is indicative to. Very large hail coming with it as it's feeding off that instability, pulling to the north, as you get all these very warm temperatures really helping with that, plus the winds aloft. There's many factors, of course, but this is your foundation right here. So as you're looking at it, and you know what you're looking at, you can see that that is bowing out all night long. So it goes all the way towards 10 and 11 o'clock towards Minnesota, Wisconsin. Then it breaks apart. It loses its instability. But then it carries overnight. And remember, all that purple to that white is large to very large hail as you go all night long. Then you go overnight where it goes across for Illinois and Indiana. This is where it brings some storms along the southern side of it. Very weak over here for Texas and Louisiana going through Mississippi, mainly as you're going through the AM for Saturday. Your Saturday is really going to pick up right after that. But this does go across Illinois, Indiana, towards Ohio. As you go overnight into the early morning hours, that's also bringing some winds with those, some 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gusts. The strongest part is going to be for Friday night as this potentially forms up. And if it stays stronger, it could go all night long into the morning, still bringing hail across southern Missouri, across southern Illinois, western Tennessee, western Kentucky, northern Arkansas. But once you go into Saturday, this is where it all concentrates in the south. This is where all those lightning strikes is bringing you a lot of hail. And this is where you get a lot of chances for strong tornadoes as these storms are building. This is all morning long for Saturday, going across Mississippi, Louisiana, transitions in the afternoon from Mississippi to Alabama. And once you go all the way for Saturday night, it's still in Alabama going through a little bit of Tennessee. Very strong storms bring a lot of hail, very robust, very strong, a lot of lightning strikes, a lot of big hail follow this storm. And that's where you're going to see also with a lot of strong tornadoes. So this is where your best chance is going to be as it goes all the way until Sunday morning. Then it expands out a little bit towards the East Coast as you're going through to Sunday severe weather threat, bringing more of a mild threat to the north, but along the south, still bringing chances for hail, even large hail still with those, even chances for tornadoes to come off those cells. That's very powerful. What we're looking at here with all this white and all these storms, that is very powerful what happens right there. And this is where that instability goes all night long into the early morning hours across Ohio Valley. That's why it keeps those storms going. Then as you go into Saturday, look right here in this section, right here in the south, where we have all those storms I just showed you with chances for the hail, strong tornadoes that can come out of that. Look at all the instability that just feeds as you go Friday night, Saturday morning, all the way until Saturday afternoon. Just sits there and feeds all the way till Sunday morning. Just feeds a banding of storms all night, all morning. Very violent looking storms as well. I think the tornado threat will ramp up still for the south. I think we'll see a moderate section, anywhere from Mississippi going towards Alabama. And this is literally where the boot is kicking that ball. And as you go towards afternoon, you get the storms building up all the way from 3-4 p.m. Starts building up from northern Missouri, a little bit of Iowa. But once you go towards 7 p.m., that's where you're going to start getting that banding, that potential derecho popping up. And as that goes into the evening, it still expands towards Minnesota, Wisconsin, going to Illinois. Then it goes overnight right across Indiana, Kentucky, a little bit of Michigan as well. Just bows out with that. Then you have what forms in Saturday, bringing all these storms all the way till Sunday, just like I just showed you. But as that boot comes in, it comes in all morning long for Friday, bringing that 50 to 60 miles per hour wind gust all the way to the early afternoon. Then it breaks that cap that it has on these storms on the eastern side. And as that breaks through, goes to that negative tilt, you get that potential derecho, bringing the 40 to 50 miles per hour wind gust. You see how it is a little weaker on the northern side, but it holds together all across Illinois, Indiana, as you go through the evening, Tennessee, Kentucky, overnight into early morning hours, and then it dissipates. But then as you go again for Saturday, it comes back. It builds right back again for Saturday evening, going right over the Great Lakes for 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gust, then what builds in the south. So now that you know what you're looking at, look here with the latest Euro. You can see as you go through the evening, there's your potential derecho with all that lightning, all the wind pushing behind it. And as you go overnight to the early morning hours, you can see how it starts to break apart, but you still have storms moving through Minnesota as well. Strong storms moving through Missouri, northern Arkansas, and Illinois. And as you go to the early morning hours for Saturday, you start weakening down, but they're still bringing the 40 up to the 50 miles per hour wind gust all the way from Indiana into Michigan. And over here from Minnesota, the storm's strengthening. This is where you're getting the chances for the storms, maybe some thunder sleet or some thunder snow across Minnesota as you go through the morning of Saturday when you get into snow and a little bit of the freezing rain. Then it is where it flurries off to the north. It pulls into Canada, and this is where you have your strong storms in the south. All the hail and all the chances for the strong tornadoes as you go all morning long for Saturday, all afternoon. It starts going through Indiana, Kentucky, Ohio, eastern Michigan. Then it stretches all night long into the early morning hours for Sunday, all the way from eastern Alabama going to Georgia, all the way to Tennessee and Kentucky. Then it slows down, it weakens down as you go through Sunday morning. And Sunday evening, it stretches out a little bit more for the northeast, bringing some winds with that as well. We watch out for that all the way across the Carolinas and the southeast. It is going to be a weaker scenario for the north, but it is going to still be some strong storms as we go all the way until Sunday. Now, this is where the difference is. GFS is still showing that it could pick up a chance for a low pressure, a 989 low pressure, where it could get stronger winds and stronger storms as you're going through Sunday morning. That's overnight Saturday into Sunday. So that's right where we're going overnight with our lift for Friday, going into Saturday with them storms all southern, going towards Indiana, Michigan, Ohio as well. Then as you go through the afternoon, this is where it starts moving towards the southeast rather quickly, I might add, all the way to Sunday afternoon. So it does move all the way from Saturday afternoon from Alabama across Georgia by the morning of Sunday. Then it goes towards the East Coast for Sunday evening, being the strongest port for the East Coast. But still, you can see right here with your dew points, it's still carrying those 55s all morning long for Saturday, still bringing those 60s, even some 70s along the Gulf, all the way into southern Indiana and to Ohio as well. And these will keep the thunderstorms going all night long, everyone, all evening, early Sunday morning, and along the East Coast for Sunday evening. The dew points are there, the lift is there, the winds aloft, there's a lot of shear. This is going to be some strong storms. Now, this is where the difference is with GFS, and it's not trending, thank God, but it won't let go of it, showing that as you get the potential derecho or big squall line popping up, bringing 40, 50 miles per hour wind gusts, maybe up to 60 as it goes by Friday night. But then it picks up the chance for that low pressure to build again as it goes through Saturday evening, bringing 50, 60, 70 miles per hour wind gusts as that goes across for Saturday night into Sunday morning, showing a lot stronger wind still by the GFS. So this is where we stand on that. You can see with the European is bringing 40, 50 miles per hour wind gust. 50 is in that orange. So you can see this all the way from the West Coast all the way across. This is going to be a cross country storm. So it is eventually bringing some winds. It's not going to be a lot of impacts for the Pacific Northwest, but it is bringing winds. You still have rain and snow coming, but all the severe weather is going to be southern. And you can see all the way from Texas to Minnesota is going to bring that 40 to 50 miles per hour wind gust and go all the way across on that pivot towards the Mid-Atlantic, towards Northeast on a weaker scenario, but still bringing some strong winds. You can see this with the Canadian as well. It's agreeing with the European. A little bit of strength maybe popping up for the Ohio Valley, but look how much difference all this is compared to the GFS. That's because it sees that low pressure system and it just sees that long track of winds. It's not trending, it's just a little worrisome. It has not let go of it yet. So when you check for the chances with the GFS ensembles, just for a 1,000 millibar storm system, showing it could reach all the way down as we go by Saturday evening, maybe a 1,000 millibar storm. But when you look for chances for a 990, it's showing 989. It's not showing that is really possible anyway, anyone. So this is showing me that it could still reach down a little bit more as it's going through Saturday evening and this starts pulling away towards the Great Lakes. I think the winds could strengthen a little bit more, but nothing crazy like we see with GFS. But here we are for Friday for your severe weather, and you can see it has grown a little bit more of your significant severe, everyone. And pay attention to this curve, because that curve is going to be important. Remember, that's chances for strong winds, at least 74 miles per hour wind gusts, or EF2 or greater tornadoes, which could exist for the southern side as well. I think we're going to have overnight supercells. So here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather event for Friday. And you can see the environment conditionally supports strong tornadoes. The severe risk will only increase as it goes into Saturday. And the latest outlook for Saturday is exactly the same, everyone. I'm still showing we could see a moderate section that could grow for Saturday. But so far, here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather event for Saturday. And Sunday, it's a lesser of the threat, especially to the north, but you still have severe weather. Here's your cities and states at risk so far. Plus, Colorado State University still has its outlook out for Saturday, showing it can still upgrade for 45% in all of this light purple and up to 60% in that dark purple. That's confidence, everybody. So thank you so much for your time, everybody. I hope this helps you understand what is going on. If this has helped you, consider hitting that subscribe button. Click the bell for updates. Also, think about another family out there. Hit that share button down below. You know how it does wonders for a video if it's worthy. Thank you again. I appreciate every single one of y'all, and I will see you again for tomorrow morning. Before I go, John 14:12-18. This is Jesus speaking. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. If ye love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. Amen. Have a great evening, everyone. Make sure you prepare the best way you can for strong winds and big hail. I think that's the biggest thing we're going to see out of this event as we go overnight Friday into Saturday for the Deep South. We cannot rule out strong tornadoes. Please be aware of that. God bless every single one of you. Keep every single one of you safe. And remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a good evening, everyone.